Welcome to part 3. In this video, we are going to continue with the reconstruction of the model, cleaning it and texturing it. Everything is set, so we can talk about the reconstruction. I can start it from the Workflow tab and calculate the model with Preview, Normal and High Quality. Or I can start it from the Reconstruction tab. Again, I have the options for Normal, Preview and High Detail. I will quickly show you a few of the reconstruction settings. In the image depth map calculation, you can choose which graphics card you want to use. I only have this one, GeForce RTX 2070. By default, the preview model will be calculated from images with an image downscale of 4, the normal detail with downscale of 2, and high detail uses the original images, so the image downscale is 1. Here we have some more settings for laser scans, but I don't have any in the project, so I will not dive into them. In the mesh calculation, you can set the minimal distance between two vertices. By default, if you use sparse point cloud is enabled, the preview model will not calculate depth maps, but uses the sparse point cloud instead. Next, you can specify a maximal vertex count per model part or force single part in normal mode. I will not touch these other more advanced settings during this tutorial. Everything is okay, and I didn't change a thing, so now I will reconstruct the mesh on normal detail. Reconstruction finished, and before I do anything else, I will first save the project again. I no longer need the 2D view, so I will change the layout to 1 plus 1 plus 1. The tutorial disappeared, but I can bring it back by changing the 2D view to the help view. Let's take a closer look at the created model. It looks nice and detailed, and if you remember, I can double-click on the model to change the pivot for easier manipulation. In the 1D's view, I will check the model's properties. The model was reconstructed under the second component. It consists of 22 parts, and it has 18.4 million triangles. When I click on it, we don't have any texturing at the moment, so we can only check the report and settings. The report shows the processing time of each step. I will continue by checking the model integrity. Everything seems okay. No corrupted triangles, coloring or texturing were detected. I will also check the model topology. Again, everything is fine and there is no need to use the clean model tool. The model is containing parts that I want to get rid of. For that, we'll look at the individual selection tools. Let's start with the lasso tool. To use it, simply hold down the left mouse button and drag the cursor over the area you want to select. If I want to add something to the selection, I will hold down the Control key while dragging with the left mouse button. Use Shift for subtraction and Control plus Shift for intersection. The same applies to camera and point selections. The next selection tool is the rectangle. Adding, subtracting and intersections work the same as with the lasso tool. Just a reminder, these tools will also select back faces of the model. The next tool is the box. This tool uses the reconstruction region to select and deselect triangles inside or outside of the region. We can try it ourselves, but before, deselect everything by clicking Deselect. Now, select the triangles inside the region. Of course, I can invert the selection as well. Deselect everything again, and this time select the triangles outside the box. This gives me the same selection as was after using invert. Try to play around with the selection tools to get the hang of it. The next selection tool is called Advanced. This tool was designed to select the largest connected component, select marginal triangles of the model, as well as triangle selections based on their size. Marginal triangles are triangles added by the reconstruction algorithm and ensure the model watertightness. RealityCapture's reconstruction algorithm creates watertight models, so if you did not photograph your subject from all sides, it will always fill out the missing parts with large triangles. Deselect them for now. A good tip is to select the largest connected component, then invert the selection and delete all the small floating parts. It looks like that I also have some small floating parts, so now I will click on Invert Selection. I will not delete them just yet, because I will use the box tool to cut out the bottom part of the model. I will adjust the region in the front view in a way the bottom part of the region is in the middle of the pedestal. I will check it from the right view just to be sure. From the back view and the top view as well. I will activate the box selection tool and add triangles outside of the box. I could have done the same with just the rectangle selection tool. After it is selected, I can filter the selection. Reality Capture created a new model, but this time without the bottom part. Model 2 has 21 parts and 16 million triangles. If I use the check topology tool again, it tells me that the model has one big hole and it is the one at the bottom. I will use the close holes tool. I will bump the max edge count to a few nines and click close holes. Reality Capture created a new model without the hole. If this grid is in the way, I can disable it by unchecking Show Grid in the Scene Context tab. While I am in the Scene Context tab, I can also turn off the visibility of the cameras. Now we have a clear view of the closed hole. Now let's get back to the tutorial that I keep forgetting about and press continue. Here's some more information on the mesh statistics so we can continue even further. Coloring and texturing are up next. Coloring creates only colors for model vertices. Texturing is creating images that are applied to the model. I will not be coloring this model, I will only generate an image texture. Coloring and texturing are located in the Reconstruction tab. The settings are right next to them, so let's check them out now. By default, texturing will use the original images with a downscale set to 1. Coloring will use images with a downscale set to 2. Here are the default unwrap parameters. By default, Reality Capture is set to create one texture with 8K maximal resolution. I will show you multiple unwraps with different settings to show you how the settings affect the texture quality and utilization. If a model doesn't have a UV map, Reality Capture will create it based on the unwrap parameters and texture the model. I like to separate the unwrapping from texturing, and that is why I will close the settings and use the unwrap tool instead. The unwrap parameters in this tool are the same as in the texture settings. The gutter is important for avoiding visible artifacts on the model during rendering. The default value 2 is enough to avoid this type of artifact in most rendering engines. Here I can choose the maximal texture resolution. Large triangle removal threshold set to 10 means the triangles with an edge that is 10 times longer than the average edge length will be mapped to only one texel. The style defines the strategy which will be used to build the UV map. If I choose the maximal resolution to be 2K, with these settings, Reality Capture will create one 2K texture. Let's try to unwrap it. It is done, and Reality Capture is using a simple checkerboard texture to preview the unwrap. To view the checkerboard, go to the Scene Context tab and choose Suite Render Mode. I could also display the vertices. This is actually a very dense point cloud. You can see it when I zoom in. This is the solid view without any color information. And this is the checkerboard displayed in Suite Mode. Now when I click on the model and check its texturing properties, we see it has one 2K texture. The texture has 91% utilization, and the texture quality is only 12%. Here is the actual texel size, and here is the optimal texel size to get 100% quality. Let's choose different settings for the next unwrap. I will set the max texture size to 16K and set the Reality Capture can create maximal 10 textures. Let's see what happens. It is done. The same model is still selected. Now Reality Capture created only one 16K texture, even though I specified max 10. One 16K texture was enough. It has only 67% utilization and the texture quality is 157%. This means that the actual texel size is smaller than the optimal texel size and we simply cannot get more color information from the images to the texture. Let's try to use different settings. This time I will select 4K and keep the max texture count to 10. Now Reality Capture created 7 textures with 4K resolution with 73% utilization with 106% quality. This time I will change the style to the fixed texel size and keep the optimal texel size. I could choose from a few options, but to get 100% possible texture quality, keep the optimal texel size. I want a 16K texture and click Unwrap. Reality Capture created one 16K texture with only 28% utilization with 100% texture quality. It cannot be better. Even if you have a model with multiple 16K textures, the 3D view will still scale the textures to fit the GPU. One 16K texture at most. Everything I talked about is explained in more detail in the help. Now we could start texturing the model, or we use the color correction tool to see if it gives us more consistent colors throughout the images. I will select one image as a reference for the other images. The very first image should be okay. To view it, change the layout to 1 plus 2 plus 1 and change the views. To use it as a reference, I need to select it in the 1Ds and enable color correction reference in its properties. The reference is set and now I will just click on correct colors. To check the difference between the original colors and the corrected ones, select the 2D view with the image and toggle show corrected on and off. The first image that I selected as a reference did not change, but if I select another image, for example this one, and zoom in a little bit to this spot, now when I toggle between corrected and not corrected, you can see the difference in the brightness of the image. I will close everything and go back to the texture settings. First, I will disable recolor model after texturing. Correct colors is set to no. If I set yes, it will trigger automatic color correction when texturing or coloring your models. The next setting enables me to ignore the color correction if I already color corrected them like now. I would like to use the correct colors, so I'll keep it at no. One more thing before texturing. I will disable the images from the outer loop that were used for the basic frame. I want to keep only the detail shots for the texturing. To do this, I will go to the Scene Context tab and enable visibility of the cameras. Switch to the top view, and in the Alignment tab, I will activate the camera lasso to select the inner cameras. Then I will invert the selection, and in the 1Ds view, disable them from texturing. You can also see in the image list that this little TX icon is not highlighted. Now I can deselect them and finally start the texturing. Texturing has finished and I noticed I did not turn off the camera lasso, so I will turn it off now. Switch from the top view to perspective view by pressing 0 on the numeric keyboard. I can also change the layout again. Keep the right view as the help and the middle view as the 3D view. And this is my nice looking textured 3D model. I will stop the video here and continue with the simplification, texture reprojection, and exporting in the next video.